Hello everyone and welcome to today's video in which we will talk about inclusive capitalism and most importantly the concept of the fortune at the bottom of the pyramid which was first developed by C.K. Prahlad and Stuart L. Hart of the University of Michigan and North Carolina. C.K. Prahlad eventually developed this concept and released a book with the same title, which discussed different ideas and strategies for manufacturers and service providers to target the poorest people in the world. But before we proceed, please remember to like this video and subscribe to Rethinking Capitalism for more videos on money, policies, and business. When one thinks about capitalism today, our first reaction is to think money and profit making, and to a degree, one would be right. Capitalism does provide best means for individuals to excel and succeed with room for healthy competition and constant innovation. However, one would be wrong if one viewed capitalism only through such a narrow lens. Capitalism, like many other ideologies, has multiple facets to it. And in this video, we shall examine one of the lesser known facets of capitalism. When we talk about the economic pyramid here, what exactly do we mean? The world economic pyramid can be said to have four tiers. Tier 1 to Tier 4, depicting different levels of consumers with different degrees of spending power. Tier 1 would have the most affluent consumers who form the minority, followed by Tier 2 and Tier 3 which have consumers from upper and middle income backgrounds. Most large-scale manufacturers and MNCs generally target these two tiers of consumers in order to maximize profits. This leaves Tier 4 consumers with lower spending power, largely ignored. A significant point to be noted here is that a majority of consumers lie in Tier 4, which composes up to roughly two-thirds of the world's population. The traditional reasoning behind ignoring Tier 4 consumers has been because of their low spending power. However, recent studies have shown that there lie a number of shortcomings in such reasoning. Firstly, the sheer number of people in Tier 4 of the economic pyramid is massive. So what does this imply for manufacturers and MNCs? Recent estimates have shown that the informal economies among the poor in developing countries account for 40 to 60% of economic activities in these countries. Further, since a large number of Tier 4 consumers are poor, they generally do not hold titles or deeds to their assets and have little to no formal education. These factors are especially important when you understand that the large amount of empirical data on the actual spending power of Tier 4 consumers has been unavailable, and the market potential just beginning to be seen here may as well be just the tip of the iceberg. This means that there is a highly probable chance that manufacturers just may have overlooked one of the largest potential opportunities until now. The bug doesn't stop here either. In addition to just massive market opportunities, there is also a growing need to focus on Tier 4 consumers. Consider for a moment the large-scale environmental degradation that our country has suffered due to rapid industrialization over the past century. Harmful practices that have already been adopted are harder to stop now due to the large sunk costs and investments involved. Tier 4 economies are now rapidly developing and have the potential to do so on a scale far more massive than already developed economies due to their large populations. This means that this is the ideal opportunity to adopt sustainable practices and avoid the mistake made by MNCs in the past. Adoption of sustainable practices now would also mean that successful implementation of such practices could shift world economies eastward into developing countries. To better understand the challenges that MNCs could face in Tier 4 economies, we can examine the example of pioneers in the field. Hindustan Unilever, for example, for over 50 years has served India's small elite who could afford MNC products. However, after receiving stiff competition from Nirmal Limited, a local firm focusing on providing detergent products to poorer consumers in rural areas, realized that the latter was winning over an otherwise disregarded market. Hindustan Unilever would go on to formulate new products targeting Tier 4 consumers while also decentralizing production, marketing, and distribution in order to better access the large labor pool available in rural area while at the same time rapidly creating new sales channels. Nirma and Hindustan Unilever are both close competitors today, with each of them holding about 38% market share. Nirma has also become one of the largest branded detergent makers in the world today. The problem with Tier 4 economies, therefore, is not that these economies have lower spending power. Rather, it is more because MNCs have adopted the wrong approach with Tier 4 economies in the past. Traditional approaches focusing on high margins cannot be followed as these economies offer low margins. Instead, profits are driven by high volumes and capital efficiency due to the large population of consumers involved. Managers will also face the challenge of addressing active markets where only poverty exists in what can be said to be a completely unorganized sector. This requires active entrepreneurial strategies as these markets require a completely different approach tailored to meet the unique challenges of Tier 4. As seen with the example of Hindustan Unilever, it will be necessary to create the buying necessity to make this market viable, in addition to improving access to products and tailoring local solutions to region-specific difficulties. An example of this would be the case of I.M. Singer & Co. in 1851, which manufactured sewing machines. While the sewing machine themselves came with a steep $100 price tag that very few women could afford, the company gave the option of providing credit to purchasers. This way, the buyers who could not afford a $100 price upfront had the option of purchasing the same sewing machines at a more affordable cost of $5 a month. While the total cost of the sewing machine would remain the same, the company suddenly made itself accessible to a much larger market than was previously available. MNCs are not the only players that are relevant in developing Tier 4 markets. In fact, the most efficient approach would require from a large number of parties ranging from governments, NGOs, and multiple MNCs in order to rapidly develop Tier 4 markets. Bangladesh's approach through Grameen banks, which operate on the principle of micro-lending on a large scale, is an excellent example of how governments can increase the spending power of consumers by generating income among the poorer players in the economy. These examples go to show that it isn't that Tier 4 consumers cannot spend money on products, but rather that these products are just not accessible to them. Considering the massive scale of population demographics in Tier 4 market and the potential for rapid population expansion, it is only inevitable that these markets will become important economic centers in the near future. All relevant players in the market have both the incentive to capitalize on these markets as well as an obligation to learn from past mistakes and to do it sustainably and efficiently to reap maximum benefits from them. This video is brought to you by Shaktiki.org. They are an impact-driven digital marketing agency. Check out their website with the link in the description below. Please like this video and subscribe to this channel for more such videos. You can also share your thoughts in the comment section below. We will see you next time. Take care.